matter if your council isn't in a position to attend or working somewhere else. Studio planning to make other arrangements and have somebody here in case it's called. I give 5 minutes when starting the case, 5 minutes whether they're here or not first accused. Your application to us amended, is it?
Yes, Judge, please.
Okay. Also, matters of hearing, I don't see it on the face of the summons. This is a matter that is kept between filing and indictment also. And I don't see any endorsement on the summons confirming that the court accepted jurisdiction. Were there DPP directions given
to the right? There were DPP directions from the court.
Summons
to the court.
And what, very briefly, is alleged?
I suppose the alleged team judges that the work someone by Irish law and be able to sit in the hole, obstructing the work, but looking at it just mere obstructing work.
Very good on that basis. It obviously constitutes a minor matter and I would accept jurisdiction. Yes, what do you say in relation to the application to amend? I suppose what you wouldn't necessarily show is in some way how you're perhaps prejudiced by the application. As I've explained to the inspector before lunch, first of all, I would be happy that there would be some prejudice, and then if it's alleged there is prejudice, it's open to me to adjourn the matter to maybe try to overcome that prejudice.
Same time.
causing some interference, it's probably better that I make that finding, but you can just describe what he was actually doing.
Okay. He was there, he was speaking to the crew members, just instructing them that water, that a lot of the residents and the houses in the area would have been very opposed to having water meter fitted to their water supply. And that was basically it. When I arrived, that's what was going on. Subsequently, I would.
That's really what you saw. You said something, right? Take a time. What you saw when you saw.
That's basically what I saw. The lads were attempting to do their work. And
so when you said they attempted to do their work, how did they do it?
They would, I suppose, to get set up, they would have set up barriers around certain.
Why would you call that barriers around certain?
Yeah, at the work zone.
The work zone, okay. Why were they doing the work zone?
What they were instructed to do was to create the work zone, excavate a hole around an existing stockpot on the water supply. Dig excavation.
And when they excavated the hole, what happened?
When they excavated the hole, ultimately what happened was that Mr. Murphy got into the hole and obstructing the workers.
Was that something you saw yourself?
Yeah.
So you say he got into the hole in the hunt video?
Well, the hole is just of a certain size.
So he stood in it?
He stood in it, that was it.
Where were you at that time?
I was in the vicinity, I was.
When you were in the vicinity, how far?
I was probably as close as I am to Mr. Murphy, you know.
And what requests were made?
On several occasions, I would have asked Mr. Murphy to please remove himself from the excavation.
And because of his presence there, what happened?
It rendered it impossible for us to complete works that we had commenced.
How long did that go on? What time did you get it?
That went on for a while. I didn't want to have to involve the Gardaí, but there was little no choice. I would approximately have the score, I would have put in a call to the Gardaí to.
How long was that after you put in the call?
I'm not sure. It could have been 20 minutes or something like that.
And during that, how long did it take the Gardaí to arrive?
I'm not sure again, but I would say it was 20 minutes and a half an hour, maybe something like that.
On to the 20 minutes of the call?
Yeah.
So in relation to, we said 20, we said 40 minutes, what were your workers doing, what could they do by this moment? Was he sitting down or standing?
A good board to be sitting down and standing, yeah.
And what work could they carry out like that installation?
None.
No.
No.
Okay, you answer this thing.
So, just in relation to your and according to you, that watering meters were not installed in those premises.
They weren't installed, did they? No.
No, thank you. Were you aware the premises that you were outside, number 4 KL Road, isn't that correct?
Number 4 is right, yeah.
And were you aware who lives in number 4 KL Road?
No.
Well, I can tell you that it was an elderly woman named Miss Betty Forrest. Did the accused, Mr. Murphy, did he ever say to you that she didn't wish the water meter to be installed?
He didn't express that the lady who owned the house didn't want it. It was, I think it was her son. Mr. Murphy would have expressed to me that that lady's son was on the phone to him at the time, and that he was opposed to it.
And this, this, that was the issue. The son wasn't present.
That's right.
So he only had him on the phone to say he was opposed to it, whether that was for, as you say, a boundary issue. I think that they were back on the boundary wall that was subsequently moved to facilitate the football. So I think there was an issue as to whether or not the residents still owned the area of the football, or whether or not that had indeed been taken charge by the county council.
And was the hole in the footpath or on the road?
On the public footpath.
But he says.
So what you're saying is that Mr. Murphy was on the phone to the son of an elderly woman,
yes,
that owned the house adjoining the public footpath of the hole, is it?
Well, it was the house that was being used. That's the issue. The son.
No, we were unable to install the meter because when Mr. Murphy, between the Gardaí arriving to site, I made a phone call to the Gardaí, they arrived to site, a number of other, I call them protesters, would have arrived on site at the time. There would have been a number of people there at the time, maybe up to 10, I'm not sure exactly, but I would say 10. So when Mr. Murphy was removed, another protester got in.
And you, at that stage, was that protester arrested for obstruction?
She wasn't arrested, no.
Did you make a formal complaint to the Gardaí in relation to obstruction?
Well, we made a complaint to the Gardaí. The Gardaí were aware at the time what they were handling or processing the arrest of Mr. Murphy. recent family bereavement.
Mm-hmm.
And we decided at this stage, look, that it was best to backfill it, make safe for the night, take them out of here and move on.
But could you not have decided that prior to
I wasn't aware of it.
Which bit
I wasn't aware that the lady had suffered family bereavement.
He had his lady's son or father really talked to you.
Well, I didn't know who was in
it. Well, can you just explain to me, because I didn't know why that to in relation to the process and made you what relevance does this have to a defence of the charge?
Well, charge I suppose it.
Charges of obstruction.
It is in relation to obstruction, but I suppose it's very much establishing the intent of my clientship. Now, I know that's not a prerequisite in relation to the
but the cross examination seems to say that I'm only going on the cross examination. Was to stop the work.
Yes, at the behest of the landowner judge, who was 8-year-old woman who recently got the bereavement and whose son had also been on that bereavement, asking him to stand in to stop the work.
Okay.
It just in relation then to, I suppose, the attitude of Mr. Murphy,
mm-hmm.
there was no sort of threatening behavior.
No.
There was no issue in relation to aggression.
I wouldn't say it was, no, it certainly wasn't threatening. There was some raised voices, but I certainly didn't beat them.
No, I think you made a statement
regarding this
matter on the third July.
Judge, we received the call at 4:30 on the 30th of July 2015. It was approximately 4:30. We would have been in Yall Town at the time. And we proceeded to go through the call. Arriving there would have been approximately 5 p.m. by the time we arrived, where I met Mr. Price at the scene.
And what did you see?
Well, Judge, when I spoke with Mr. Price, he pointed out to me the work zone, which he was working on at the time, and he pointed out to me the man inside in the work zone who was allegedly obstructing him continuing his work. The work zone, it would have consisted of barriers around a hole in the ground. The hole is probably up to Mr. Murphy's waist. And Judge, when I went out to speak to Mr. Murphy, he firstly refused to give me his name and address within. Eventually, he gave his name as Finbarr Murphy of Grange Castle Manor.
What did he tell you he was doing?
Judge, he told me that he was protesting on behalf of the anti-water Irish Water Campaign, Judge. And it was on behalf of the Forrest family, who he said that he was friends with, and that they had given him permission to protest on his behalf on their behalf. Judge, there was, from what I can recall, there was 3 other protesters there at the time. Now, these were non-local protesters, I think, from what I can remember. 2 of them were from Cove and had been involved in other protests before. I didn't take the details because they weren't instructed at the time, Judge. But from what I can recall, there was 3 other protesters at close proximity to Mr. Parker when he was standing in the box.
And what did Mr. Murphy say to you?
Well, when I asked Mr. Murphy that he was committing an offence by obstructing
cooperated with you.
He fully cooperated, Judge. There was never any hassle with him. He walked out of the hall and came with us and conveyed it to me.
Services Authority, and that to me is exercise of their authority.
Well, Judge, I just respect
own disagreement if that's the case. But I find that the if they employ subcontractors to do the work on the behalf, that is part of the exercise of their authority. It would, if you look at another angle, it would mean give rise to a ridiculous situation that if you had Irish Water on the side of the road carrying out works where they had their own employees and contractors working together, if somebody interferes, but we've got to find out which ones were direct employees of Irish Water, which were subcontractors, you're committing an offence if it's a direct employee, not a subcontractor. No, I don't think that's what the legislation said.
Santa Claus for years, and he was had. He would have been a regular visitor anyway at my house with my children, even in my youth. And we had a long respected respect and relationship with him.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes.
And so when you arrived at
with regard to the installation of the water meter, and she said that she objected, she did not approve, and she did not consent to it. And therefore, I said that I would speak to Martin, her son, and that I would probably present myself and express that. Myself. The hole was, even though clever evidence would indicate it was up to my waist, it was my waist. And I placed myself in the hole, and I respectfully asked both the installer of the water meters and the guardian that the hole should be reinstated and to return for.
And you had Mark Price.
categorically that I was acting on behalf of the Forrest family and that their wishes were to have the footpath reinstated, and that was ignored.
And were you aware of
any scenarios
of this?
I was aware of this.
And to your knowledge, what was the response of
their concerns were the Mr. Guy's communicated with one or two of them, and there were no meters installed on their premises.
At any time, did you become threatened or abusive?
Not in the slightest.
And after Dorothy and Guy had arrived, you spoke with them?
Yes.
Outlined the position?
Yes.
And are you in agreement that they did ask me?
Yes, they did. And I asked them, I again reiterated my position that I was preventing the interference of the person's property by a third party, and again stated that this should be reinstated the footpath and everybody would go home happy.
And so, just finally, what was your purpose for standing in the right of the lot?
What did I do? Because I think I respected the fact that this was an elderly woman, and it was very easy to ignore some people in life, and I had Martin Forrest on the phone, and I knew that if I wasn't there, or if Martin was there, that he would probably have done the same thing, in my opinion. But that's not what occurred. So I took up that decision. But I spoke to Martin on the phone, and he reiterated that he was. Yes.
Thank you, sir.
You
might answer.
Just Mr. Murphy, your presence in that hall standing, wasn't that obstructing the work of action? If you weren't there, how would it happen? You didn't go in there at all.
Absolutely, my presence was obstructing.
Your presence. I know where your presence is. Thanks, Mr. Moore.
This wasn't in this man's mind, or was it an issue of anything?
Well, I think it all wasn't in mind, Judge.
Just one question, Mr. Murphy. Why did you refuse initially to give your name and address to the guard even asked?
I suppose it was. I didn't realise that I was legally bound to, so I wasn't.
Why did you feel? I'm just trying to get a flavour of what your intentions were and what your views were. And
my intentions were very loud.
If you were stopped normally by the guardian in the street, would you normally refuse to give your name and address?
I've had no reason in my life to.
If you were.
If is an hypothetical.
Okay, well then
I have never had.
So then tell me, so no hypothetical, why did you refuse to give the guardian your name and address on this?
Because I was not aware of the fact that I was legally bound to do so. That's not unreasonable.
Good, right. Anything arising out of that?
Well, I suppose, Judge, just in relation to the issue in relation to the boundary, were you aware that there was a dispute in relation to the boundary?
At the time, I can't say categorically whether it was or not.
Very good.
Thank you.
Well, just related to that, the boundary, I take it this is the council footpath, it's outside of the law.
Well, you see, the property
just
is extended. The property is, from what I'm aware of, properties would have extended further out to the probably out to the centre of the road originally, and then subsequently altered to put in a permanent footpath for safe pedestrian access.
Thank you.
You can sit down.
Thank you.
Call Mr. Martin Forrest.
bear on things, because all I'm being asked to decide here is whether Finbarr Murphy is guilty of the offence of obstruction.
Yes.
Whatever other people think you found it, he said straight up and said there's own evidence that
he was
so why whether there was a bounty issue, why is that relevant to his state of mind whether he committed an offence on the date? Whether there was a bounty he didn't know about it, if there was a bounty issue in relation to other parties that he's unfamiliar with.
But I know that he said that he definitely didn't know about it at the time he was before. So
I'm sure, but they wouldn't allow it to come. It wasn't very big, actually.
I expected you to be able to has pretty much control ownership. This footpath will be taken charge by the authority, regardless of what's in the
neighborhood. We just put that in place.
I know, for
sure.
I don't believe it has to be a public case, but so.
And if you would like
to? You would.
Thank you. Any other witnesses?
The inspector of that, with just the exception of the failure to give the name that was on the lower end of obstruction.
He was fully cooperative with that. He just, it was a witness.